With Dragon Ball Super Episode 62 scheduled to air tonight, today guys, we're going ahead and dive into the official comment section of my recent video entitled Let's Talk Trunks' New Superpower in Dragon Ball Super Episode 62 to better understand what the entire community had to say and revolves to Trunks' new superpower. And with that being said, guys, let's go ahead and dive down into the comments, beginning with our very first comment by Charlie. If that were false Super Saiyan God, he wouldn't be able to do crap because he would be weaker than Goku and Vegeta. Then it must be some sort of Ultra Super Saiyan God missed transformation or something like that, similar to when he went against Cell, as you said, in order for him to stand a chance against them, for at least for a while. I also think he is totally capable of becoming blue. I mean, why not? Well, that could be debatable. Even easier than Goku and Vegeta, such as Gohan reached Super Saiyan 2 faster and younger than them because of their bloodline, don't you think? Besides all that, it's very hard to say what it would take to defeat them at this point. There are so many possibilities. Yes, there are. But the thing about Trunks is, if you put this logically in order, if Trunks by some chance were to achieve a form even higher than Goku and Vegeta, for the time being, don't you think he would at least have enough power to take someone like Black down? Because as strong as Goku Black is, if Trunks exceeds him in terms of power, don't you guys think that Trunks should be capable of putting him down first? Granted, the fact that Zamasu is immortal, having to take out Goku Black first would seem logical enough given the fact that he does not, you know, possess immortality. So I think that if Trunks were gradually stronger than Goku and Vegeta, in which case we're going to find out tonight as Dragon Ball Super Episode 62 airs, in which case I'll be doing my review on, so I hope to see you guys later on tonight too as we talk about this, because it's going to be very important. But again, in terms of bloodline, you're right, Gohan was able to reach Super Saiyan 2 faster and at a much younger age than Goku and Vegeta because of his bloodline being he's a half-breed, so half-breeds do have the advantage here. But I still stand on the fact that he is somewhat of a false Super Saiyan God. I personally would have enjoyed to see Trunks become a Super Saiyan Blue over this, because this doesn't give us any sort of clarity as to what the transformation is. Maybe tonight we're gonna find out, but I really doubt we're actually gonna dive into what this actually is. I think that Trunks is just gonna display his power and that's about it. But in terms of them telling us what this is, I think they're gonna hold off for that, at least for the time being. So it says here, Black has no reason to destroy Earth, just humans, and Trunks is stronger than Super Saiyan Blue, Goku, and Vegeta at this point. Vegeta said hybrids have more potential, that is true. Once Trunks gets beaten down again by Black, making him Black even stronger, Vegeta will grow stronger than both Goku and Trunks, only to lose and make Black even stronger. That Mafuba is just another reason to stall the show. Watch Black get contained. Who wants to see that? Well, I agree. I mean, who wants to see Black get contained and put under the Mafuba technique? But then again, we saw Roshi fail, so I really hope that, and it may sound weird here, I really hope that if Goku were to do that against the coming fusion that's going to happen in later on, I really hope that Goku fails. But then again, you have to ask yourself, how else are you supposed to defeat an immortal without, you know, using some sort of technique to seal them away? You can't really kill them, you can't really, you know, hurt them by bodily damage, so what else can you do? Now, you're saying here that Vegeta said that hybrids have more potential. Yes, they do. And you said here that Vegeta will get stronger than both Goku and Trunks, only to lose and make Black even stronger. I think that at some point you're saying that Vegeta will grow stronger, and I need to know what you mean by that. How exactly will Vegeta exceed Goku and Trunks only to lose to Black? I want to know down below. Do I believe that he's going to become stronger? No. Do I believe that he's going to put on a ferocious fight against Black and Zamasu? Yes, because Vegeta's not a dumb fighter. But then again, I don't think he's going to take these dudes lightly either. So I do think that Vegeta is going to, you know, survive a little longer than Trunks. But either way, I think that, you know, just Vegeta in terms of surpassing Goku and Trunks, there has to be something very critical for that to happen, like i.e. Bulma getting killed. Can you imagine if something happened to Bulma? I think at that very moment, yeah, I mean, Vegeta would snap, because that would give him all the reasons in the world to just go ham. And we saw what happened when Bulma got slapped by Beerus, you know, like Vegeta just lost his mind. So only if by some chance, I think, if Goku Black were to do something to Bulma, that would make Vegeta snap. But aside from that, I really doubt that she's going to come into play here. And I do believe that Vegeta will not exceed Goku and Trunks in terms of power. Gohan did train Trunks his entire life, hence Trunks can use the Masenko. It's a form of mystic Trunks, just like Gohan. We can't really say. I mean, first of all, there's nothing majestic, there's nothing magical about, you know, like the form that he has. That's why it should not be called mystic Trunks, because there's nothing majestic about him. Yeah, surely he has awesome like power. I mean, he stands out amongst the rest, but the term mystic implies magical or mystique. And there's nothing really Mystique or magical about Trunks. I would have to say probably Ultimate Trunks, but not Mystic Trunks. Like, I think that's like the wrong term to call it. But I mean, I understand what you're saying there. If you watch episode 62 preview, it is beyond Super Saiyan God Super Saiyan, because Super Saiyan God is basically less power than Super Saiyan Rose. But in the preview, Goku says that Trunks is beating a black Goku and has a technique that can kill Zamasu. That is true. However, I think that the new move will explode, just like how Vegeta killed Buu by the destruction of himself. Well, I don't agree with that. I think that Zamasu and Black are going to figure out a way how to put Trunks down. And keep in mind, Trunks is fighting two people. One of them is weak, but he's immortal. The other one is strong as fuck, and he's not immortal. So the one that he's primarily fighting is the one that can gradually improve. So how the hell do you fight somebody and keep him down if he's gradually going to be improving? I think Black and Zamasu are the greatest villains so far in Dragon Ball, because they've displayed such, you know, such menacing deeds and such, you know, just crazy acts of like genocide. They've committed mass genocide and they're going to continue to do it. So in terms of like Trunks using some sort of technique that was similar to when Vegeta was killed by Buu by destruction of himself, that's not going to happen. But I think that Black's going to be the one that put him down ultimately enough. I personally believe, it's my own opinion, Trunks is on the verge of a new Super Saiyan God form. Interesting. Why do you say that? I want to know down below. Just like Ultra Super Saiyan Trunks in the Cell Saga DBZ, Trunks has that he will pass Vegeta. And that's exactly what is happening now. Sadly enough, yeah, we're going to have to see if he's beyond Vegeta, because, man, I'm still not buying into the fact that despite all the fucking training Vegeta did just to have his son surpass him, it doesn't seem fair to me. But you know what? The show's not entirely fair, like, of in and of itself. So, about the end of the day, just a fanboy prediction. Peace and love, and DBS forever. Listen, man, I don't have a problem with fanboy prediction. Predictions are made to be right or wrong. That's why I love hearing your opinions, guys, because I wanna compare my opinion to yours. We're all fans here. I mean, like, we talk Dragon Ball in the comments, so that's all I really care about, is to know what you guys have to say. In terms of Trunks revealing somewhat of a new Super Saiyan God form, I don't think that's the case. I think that maybe he's tapped into something that Goku and Vegeta can learn from and adapt on their own, since they're pure Saiyans, they're not half-breeds. But in terms of Trunks unlocking, you know, a new Super Saiyan God form, I can't buy into that. I'm sorry, I don't think that's the case at all. Could this be that this is Super Saiyan Blue 2? I don't think so, to be honest with you, man. First off, Trunks is one of my favorite characters in Dragon Ball, but this transformation is bullshit. Ooh, okay. Like I said before, transformations means new look, new attributes, and powers, but Toriyama is a lazy fucking dude. Ooh, that is dragging this bullshit story along, period. Okay, guys, before you go off on Seth here, I respect his opinion. I see where he's coming from. Let's just go on. And Goku Black ain't shit, but a little bitch. Ooh, Toriyama chose to push this bullshit story. Trunks' transformation isn't shit either, but some rainbow Skittle color bullshit. But look who it is. It's a lazy, non-creative dude who would have to reach back into the old series long done. DBZ used to be on some old shit. Thank Toriyama, aka lazy ass fuck Dragon Ball creator. Wow. Okay, so you're upset on the fact that Trunks doesn't look different. I can kind of see your point in terms of Trunks looking different, because every transformation over the past years of Dragon Ball had looked different. Even Super Saiyan 2 compared to Super Saiyan 1, people are going to say, oh, that's impossible, they look the same. No, they don't. Super Saiyan 1 and Super Saiyan 2 have different hair variations. Super Saiyan 2 is more spiked up. Sometimes you would see, like, instead of two strands of hair, you have one strand of hair. And Super Saiyan 2 traditionally in Dragon Ball Z had lots of electricity, whereas opposed to Super Saiyan 1 did not. Similar to Super Saiyan 3, long hair, you know, rigid eyebrows. Super Saiyan 4, some can argue GT, you know, muscular as fuck, you know, hair everywhere. These new transformations are simply color redone, I guess you could say. But again, the new confirmation of Shueisha opening up a new department for Dragon Ball, we can only expect more from that. So let's just keep our fingers crossed they're going to keep giving us more and dynamic looks, as well as, you know, features and stuff. You look like John Travolta. Wow, though, I guess, I don't know. I feel like Trunks is a false Super Saiyan God Super Saiyan. Then Black will demolish him, leaving him on the brink of death. That's when Vegeta comes in and goes into rage mode. Goku gives Trunks a Senzu, and then he sees his dad get demolished, and he goes full Super Saiyan God Super Saiyan. It could happen, but you are forgetting the fusion. Zamasu and Black, spoiler alert, guys. I'm pretty sure a lot of you guys already know by now. Zamasu and Black are going to fuse, which is going to create some really strong-ass fucking enemy. In which case, I would love to see three Super Saiyan Blues fight this fusion, but I don't even think Trunks is going to reach that at all. I think Trunks is going to fall back for a little bit, just to see what's going to happen with Goku and whatnot, because he went back into the past to see if he can learn something. He fails, and then that's when we get to commence with this fusion. Now, in terms of, you know, Trunks seeing his dad ultimately get decimated, I don't think he ought to turn Super Saiyan Blue right there, because can you imagine if Trunks really did go Super Saiyan Blue just to have him get beat down by the fusion? You get what I'm saying? Like that doesn't make any sense at all, to me at least. So I would have them skip out on that, because it wouldn't seem fair to Trunks just to unleash the Super Saiyan Blue form for the first time ever and get his ass beat. Trunks has Divine Mode Super Saiyan or something like Gohan Mystique Transform. Nothing majestic about it, man. It's definitely a somewhat of a new form, but nothing mystique about him, to be honest. A little like Goku in Dragon Ball when the androids died, in a way. You got to remember that this is that Trunks has been fighting a god for a while now. Yes, Trunks has been fighting Black for a very long time, so I'm pretty sure, Sam, that he's been gradually getting some Zenkai boosts as well, but I mean, not as fast as Black. Black wrecked all three of them. I mean, you saw in the episode 61, he was barely moving around. He was kicking the shit out of them. So how can anybody argue against me the fact that Black beat all three of them down? You know, he gradually improves at such a rapid pace. This dude is the Don of this series right now. Like, he is the man. In Dragon Ball, Bulma was a teen and Chi-Chi was like Kid Goku. Why in Dragon Ball Z she looks younger than Chi-Chi? All right, so this is like an age debate. Goku and Vegeta can get clothing changes. Trunks and Goten need a little change. Well, yeah, Trunks and Goten definitely need to mature a little bit. It's been years, you know, following Majin Buu and stuff. So how come they're not older is beyond me. But I really hope that they actually change that, because us fans are starting to notice that shit. Theory, maybe that could be the true Super Saiyan instead of it being a god. Maybe that's the true Super Saiyan form after Super Saiyan 1. Maybe that can be Super Saiyan 2 Prime or some shit. Again, I don't want to argue against your theory. It could be, it could not be. I really doubt it's something that's a true Super Saiyan. Again, I'm sticking to my theory that this is a false Super Saiyan God, as seen with when Goku fought Slug, as seen when Trunks was on the verge of fighting Cell. He had the Super Saiyan 2 ability in a way, but even Cell pointed out that he did the transformation wrong. He increased his power, and he lost all his speed. When Gohan became Super Saiyan 2 in front of everyone, Trunks specifically said he did it right. He increased his strength without losing speed. So, you know what I'm saying? So I think this is like the brink of Super Saiyan Blue, except Trunks wasn't able to push right through. The half-breed theory, that the half-Saiyan and half-humans have the ability to get stronger than full-blood Saiyan. That's true. That is true. Has he gotten stronger? Yes. Is he surpassed Goku and Vegeta? I hate to believe it. I mean, is it possible? Yes. But I just personally don't think so. Yeah, he's able to kick Black's ass, but how long until Black turns the tires on him? You get what I'm saying? And your comments are crazy here. Let me just scroll a little further down below, just see what you guys had to say. Your voice doesn't match your body, and that shirt made me think you were... I am buff, by the way. I love your videos. Thank you so much. Super Saiyan Demigod Trunks. Ah, man. The whole demigod thing. It's like, why that? You know, it's just like, I mean, do I mind it? Not at all. But it sucks that Gohan doesn't have any of this. My God, has he fallen off the totem pole? Jesus Christ. Enough with the transformations already. Let their fight intelligence evolve, like Vegeta is maturing with strategy instead of brute force. Chill with the transformation crab is what I believe. Best comment. Well, you're saying enough with the transformations. Give us like raw fighting strategies and intelligence and stuff. Yeah, I agree in a way. But so far, it's just been Super Saiyan Blue in the show. We had Super Saiyan God be introduced, but that was only for like, you know, a few episodes. So it's been Super Saiyan Blue the entire time. So I'm guessing they're trying to change it up. But maybe they're going to change it like as the show continuously progresses, like, you know, more and more. Who knows? I mean, anything can happen at this point, in my opinion. So, false God. Remember in Dragon Ball Z movie, Goku was a false Super Saiyan. Yeah, I get it, but the movies can't be accounted for because they're non-canon. But then again, I still stand on the theory that he is a false god. You missed the fact that Black had a special time ring that Trunks created accidentally after he went back in time. No. I am completely aware of that, to be honest. The green rings, but I mean, nobody has used the green rings yet. So that time ring has special features because of the reason. Rewatch episode 61 and you'll see Black is pretty much... Okay, well, that's the thing. It's like, yeah, sure, there are the other time rings, the other green rings, but nobody is using them. So they're not really put into account yet because there's nothing really specific about them that should be noted other than, you know, Black's time ring, and that's about it, really. I'm from Jamaica. I simply have to say that Trunks is nowhere near Super Saiyan Blue. You're right on the money. This is false Super Saiyan Blue. Anyone with eyes can see and agree. Well, thank you, and greetings from America, I guess. How's Jamaica treating you, bro? I really enjoyed your explanation and discussion. Excellent. Thank you. I really appreciate when you guys leave comments like this. Like, that actually motivates me a lot. So thank you all so much. Let's see here. I know I'm going to get hate for this, but I would like it to be a base form Broly made an appearance somehow. Oh, shit. Maybe in a form of... Alright, so you want to... Alright, Mr. Popo wants to see Broly come back. Why? Why is it that you want to see Broly come back is my question. Dragon Ball Super Episode 62 is going to explain everything tonight, hopefully enough. You guys know what I just realized. When Black stole Goku's body, Goku had Goten, which means Buu Saga, which means Super Saiyan 3. And he's never been that, you know, careless since Captain Ginyu and Black hadn't had that power boost yet. What? What? Which means Super Saiyan 3 should have been enough to kill Black. You can't really say that should have been enough, because depending on which variation of Super Saiyan 3 we're talking here, if it's Buu Saga Super Saiyan 3, if it's Battle of God Super Saiyan 3, if it's Resurrection F, if it's, you know, Universal Tournament Super Saiyan 3, they're all different in terms of power because Goku has gradually gotten stronger with them. But, I mean, could Super Saiyan 3 have defeated Black during that time where he stole Goku's body? I mean, maybe. I mean, that all depends on which Goku he stole. I mean, we saw when he, you know, invaded, you know, the area and he killed Chi-Chi and Trunks. And I want to think that that was the beginning of Dragon Ball Super when Goku was working. So that could have been, you know, beyond the Buu Saga and then before Battle of Gods. But then again, we're not entirely too sure. But either way, it's still Goku's body. So Black retains all that shit. So he can't really be beaten that easy. You look way different than how you sound. Thank you, man. Well, I a lot of your comments here, like, in case you guys have something different to say, comment down below. I think human blood can be somewhat of a catalyst in Saiyans, hence why Gohan could reach Super Saiyan 2 before Goku, or maybe humans have a bigger emotional reserve to pull from. Hybrids are usually stronger than the original. Yes, Trunks has the advantage here, my friend, but it just doesn't seem to me that Trunks has reached a new level of power that allowed him to ascend past Vegeta and Goku. I think that this is still going to stand on the fact that he is a false Super Saiyan, and with those attentions behind him, I don't think that he's going to be able to do much damage, maybe in the beginning, but how long until Black turns the tides on him, you get what I'm saying? So, but you're right, I mean, humans do have a bigger emotional reserve to pull from, hence, you know, when Trunks became a Super Saiyan for the first time when he saw Gohan die, Gohan, you know, same thing when he saw 16 die, so we can compare that, and it's very accurate. Damn, a lot of your comments here, holy shit. But again, guys, I just want to say thank you all for watching. If you guys are excited for tonight's episode, make sure to finger that like button. If you guys enjoyed the video, make sure to also subscribe in case you guys are new to the channel for more Dragon Ball content. Yo, man, I love your vids. Few things keep in mind: Trunks, Gohan, and Goten are half Saiyan. Everyone keeps bringing up, you know, the half Saiyan thing, and I agree, Lenny. Yes, even though they are half Saiyans, you're saying here that he maxes out his power, declines, and he has Trunks exposed to God Ki right away. Yes, he was, because he trained with Vegeta, so he is exposed to the God Ki, but that does not mean that he has the, you know, ability now. Well, I mean, it's not like he doesn't have the ability, because surely I do think that at some point he can become stronger than Goku and Vegeta, but as of right now, maybe he's either equal to them or just a little bit below them, because I don't really see, you know, Vegeta or Goku being, you know, just put under Trunks as of right now, because even though Trunks and he got a giant hole blown inside of him, so like, where's the hole, you know what I'm saying, like how did he recover? But in terms of Trunks being stronger than them, I don't know, man, it's gonna be a little hard to say, because we don't really know what's gonna happen, but I do think that at some point he's gonna reveal that he is you know, sort of like around the same caliber as Black. But I think that even with all the damage that Trunks is gonna give to Black, Black's gonna bounce right back, and he's gonna kick some ass. So, but again, guys, thank you all for watching. I hope you guys tune in for the review tonight, alongside the predictions and tons of more stuff. If you guys want to go in ahead and play with me on Xenoverse 2, let me know in the comments. Thank you all for watching, guys. Once again, have a blessed day, and I'll be seeing you all later on tonight. Take it easy, guys. Peace.